Come and check out a cute outfit that I made for the Sew Maxi for Mother's Day Sewing Challenge using the Mave Skirt and the Ogden Cami from True Bias Patterns. Hi YouTube, I'm Crystal of crystalsewsandstuff.com. Welcome back to the channel today where I share sewing pattern reviews, sewing tips and techniques, and other fun content. So today I'm going to be sharing with you my review of the Mave Skirt by True Bias Patterns. And this is the newest pattern that was released by True Bias Patterns. And I really love this skirt and it has a ton of options. So now let me tell you a bit more about this pattern. So this skirt pattern is designed for lightweight woven fabrics such as rayons, crepes, cotton voiles, and linens and georgette. So all of those kind of lightweight drapey fabric would work really well for this. And it's suggested that you choose a fabric with a width of at least 54 inches. And I'm guessing that's because of the ruffles on the bottom because they're pretty wide. And so you need to have a lightweight fabric with that's 54 inches or wider in order to sew it up. And then there are several length options for the pattern. So you can sew it up as a mini skirt, a midi skirt, or a maxi skirt. And then you can also add tiers. So you have the option to add one or two tiers to any of those length options. And I do like the versatility of the pattern. And then there are also inseam pockets. And I just love the directions for the pockets. They were very, very detailed on how to install because they have you tack down the top and bottom of the pocket pieces so that they'll stay in place. They also give you directions on how to go ahead and understitch the pockets. And you guys know that I love to understitch pockets, especially for side inseam pockets because it helps your pockets lay down a lot more nicely. So there are two size ranges for the pattern. It comes in sizes 0 to 18 for the first size range, and then it comes in sizes 14 to 30 for the second size range. So there's a little bit of overlap between the sizes. And the 0 to 18 size is for waist of 26 inches to 38 and a half inches, and then for hips of 34 inches to 46 and a half inches. And then the 14 to 30 size range is for waist sizes of 34 and a half to 50 and a half inches, and for hips of 43 and a half inches to 59 and a half inches. So a great size range there. And then there's also a lot of ease built into the pattern. So for my size, well, there was about 8 inches of ease above my hip measurement. And so there's a lot of ease in the pattern. So you can even have an even wider size range available for the pattern. And also included in the pattern are directions for you to go ahead and line the skirt. So if you have a sheer fabric like a georgette or a chiffon or some kind of embroidered fabric, you can go ahead and line it, and there are directions already included in the pattern for you to go ahead and line the skirt as well. So I like having that option available. I sewed a size 12 for this skirt and I didn't have to make a lot of pattern alterations. So the only pattern alterations I had to make were for height. I took 2.5 inches off the main front and back skirt piece as well as 2 inches off the tier. And so that's how I got it to fit me for my height. So there aren't a lot of pattern pieces in this pattern. There are only 6 pattern pieces total. And I only use 5 because I only sewed 1 tier. So you have your front pattern piece that's cut twice. And that piece is your front and your back. And that's cut on the fold twice. And then you have your tier that's also cut on the fold twice. And then you have a second tier option as well. And then you have your pocket pieces. And then you have your waistband piece that's cut as just one long piece, as well as your ties right here for the front of the skirt. And I love the way the ties are constructed. Instead of doing the turnout method where you sew down one long side and leave a hole and then turn it out, have you fold it in twice in order to, so you fold it in towards the center and then you fold it again to go ahead and then you sew that all down to get one long strip. So that's a lot easier to go ahead and make ties. So the sewing instructions were very clear and detailed, and this pattern is rated for a beginner. So I totally agree with that assessment of the pattern because there aren't a lot of pattern pieces and they really walk you through each step. And there's also a sew along on their blog that just for this pattern, and I really like that about it. And so I think any beginner can easily get through this because it's very detailed, and they really walk you through any trickier points, because they really walk you through the pockets as well as how to do the ties. And I really like that, those details. And they also really walk you through slowly how to go ahead and sew on the waistband, even if you don't use the blog post. But the blog post is even more detailed, so if you get a little stuck, you can just go ahead with that. The only thing you might want to go ahead and practice ahead of time is how to do buttonholes, because you do have to make some buttonholes for the waist ties in the front of the skirt. So if you've never done buttonholes, I would advise you to go ahead and do a couple of practice trial runs before you go ahead and put the buttonholes onto your main fabric. But other than that, it was very easy and straightforward. And when you put in the waistband, what they have you do is insert your elastic, and then you go ahead and stitch down the elastic using your preferred stretch stitch on your sewing machine. And I use a triple straight stitch on my sewing machine, and I just love how it turned out. It was really easy to do and very straightforward. And most sewing machines nowadays have that stitch on there on the machine. All of my sewing machines have that option on them. So, but you can also just do a really narrow zigzag, so something like 2x2 or something like that, to go ahead and do that instead, because you still need something, some kind of stretch stitch, for you to go ahead and sew that down. And they explain that you have to pull a little bit as you're sewing it down to go ahead and make the waistband, the little designs. And you can even really skip that part, because it's not completely necessary, I think, because the elastic stays in. It's just a detail for style. So the fabric that I chose is a Mimi G Rayon zebra print from Melanated Fabrics, and it's in the colorway Teal. Now, this particular colorway is not available right now. Just check the site, but it is available in three other colorways. It's available in black, blush, as well as a brown. So you can still pick up this fabric if you were interested in picking up this print, but just not this particular colorway. But it's a really cute fabric. It sewed up very well. I didn't have any problems working with the fabric. It pressed really well. So after, even though, you know, rayon is usually pretty wrinkly, after I pressed it out, it stayed nice and pretty wrinkle free. I mean, it'll get a couple of creases throughout the day, but for the most part, it's pretty, it didn't wrinkle too much. So I like that about this fabric. I also decided I wanted to go ahead and sew up the Ogden Cami, which is the most famous pattern from True Bias Patterns, and it's the other pattern that I have from True Bias. So I thought it would be really cute for me to go ahead and make a matching top so that I can have kind of a faux dress look when I wore these pieces together. And so I'm loving how this Ogden Cami turned out, and I've had this pattern for a couple years. I bought it within a couple years of it coming out, and when I bought the pattern, it only came in sizes 0 to 18, but now they've expanded their size range for the Ogden Cami as well, so it also goes in sizes 14 to 30, and then the larger size range also has bust darts for the front, and then the straps are a bit wider. So I like that about the pattern. And then there's also even a girl's version with a different, it doesn't have the scoop back, it has just like a straight back. So I like that you can sew this up in so many different sizes. And the girl's range, I believe, comes in sizes 0, size 2 to 10. So a nice size range for everyone. So I really like this style of pattern, and I see why it's so popular. And I've sewn two Ogden camis before. I did like a blue one in a crepe back satin, as well as a purple one in a poly satin that I made from a bridesmaid's dress. And I have a video where I share how I went on ahead and hacked a bridesmaid's dress and made a little set from it. So I'll leave that below so you can go ahead and check that out. And there aren't a lot of pattern pieces for the Ogden cami. You just have your front, your back, you have a front facing and then a back facing and then a strap. So not a lot of pattern pieces. And both the Ogden cami and the Mave skirt are both available in printed versions as well as PDF versions, along with your AO set, you know, large scale printable print shop copy versions, the AO version. So I really like that about this pattern. So now here are some pics and twirls of me wearing this really cute skirt and top outfit.
Thank you.
All right, those are the pics and twirls of the Ogden Cami and Mave Skirt combo. I'm really loving how they look together, but I also love the versatility of these pieces, and I can wear them with different things in my wardrobe. So I can wear the top with a cute blazer and some jeans, and so I could dress it up or down, and then I could wear the skirt with maybe a bodysuit or something like that. So I really like the versatility of having separates. Let me know what you think. Are you a separates kind of person? Do you sew more separates, or do you sew more dresses? I kind of do both. I would say I do more dresses, but I do love it when I go ahead and decide to do separates, because I get way more use out of them that way. Because in my everyday life, sometimes I would just wear jeans and stuff, and I'm out with the kids, and so I just need a cute top or something like that to go with some jeans, just to dress up an outfit. So anyway, let me know. Do you prefer sewing separates or a one piece like a jumpsuit or a dress? Let me know in the comment section. I'd love to know, and that'll get a conversation started. So that is my review. Go ahead and give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, go ahead and hit the subscribe button and hit the bell notification so that you won't miss out on any future videos. All right. Thanks for watching. Take care now. Bye.